Hi, my name is Roger. This video is about a background process. Now, first of all, we're going to need something for that. This here is a screenshot, of course, of this particular website. You can download FMPEG from this website. I will place a link in the description to this website, but also to fmpeg.org. If you want to write professional software and sell it, it would be kind to donate to FMPEG. But of course that's your choice. Here you have, when you exit this website, you get to see this blue button over here, download build. You click on this button, then you get this screen. Now this one is of course in Dutch, but you have to save it to your somewhere on your computer, doesn't matter where, as long as you save it. Then you get this file, this one. You unzip it, you get this file over here. You double click on it and you want the bin file. Now when you double click on this one, you get three executables. Do not double click on one of them because you don't have to. We are going to use this one, but do not install this on your computer. You do not have to install any of them in order to make use of them, and I'm going to show you, of course, how you can make use of something that is not even installed on your computer and simply keep it out of sight. So no one will know that you use FMPEG unless they start looking for it in their computer, of course, because you have to give it with your utility or your program. So let me open this one I like to have over here. You can't see it, but this is my screen recorder. This is actually an interface to FMPEG, and that's why I start with the background process. In future videos I want to show you how you can write one yourself like this, and of course I'm also want to show you how you can write a sound recorder with this, but you want a background process in order to keep FMPEG on the background so everyone will believe that's your own program. So let me show you what this one does. You click on the open button, then we have to browse a little bit. Well, this here is FMPEG. It's not installed on my computer. We'll do it like this, FMPEG, open. And then this button says devices. I will click on it one time. Let me do it like so. And this here is the output of that executable file. So it's simply FMPEG. And in future videos, we want this here. This here is my sound card. Now, when we going to write the sound recorder, you want this. So how can you do this without showing that you use another program? Well, let me show you first the interface. This is your interface, and you can see here on the bottom this weird sign. Well, this is not a weird sign, of course, it is a shell. You go to the library here on the right. This here is your shell. Now when you drag and drop it, it's called shell 1. I go to the inspector and I've called it FMPEG shell. And here underneath behavior, you have to select mode 2. If you want to know what this does or what it means, go to the help file, type in shell, and then select mode. There are only three options. You have nil, one, and two. But in this particular case, we need to have two over here. So we go to the left. File types. Well, you know how you can do that by now. This is a folder item. This is a string. The browse button, or the open button. I simply called it open, but you could call it browse. Has an open dialog. Now, very short, if you use browse, select folder, then you can select only this here. But we want an item inside this folder, so you need an open dialog. If you do not use an open dialog, you can't select FMPEG. So you want to select FMPEG, and then you will need an open dialog, in case you don't know. Then we go to the shell. This here is my shell. I simply gonna read this out loud for you. If fmpeg shell is not equal to nil, then, well, then we have something to read or to show, and we're going to do that. Text area 1.text is fmpeg shell dot result. You can do read all or something like that, but you do not want that over here. Why? If you do result, you get all the result here. Otherwise, you get only the last line or the first line or whatever. So you want all the result. That's what that does. All the result, and this is the main part for us. Let me make it a little bit smaller. Out of the way. Then this button, it's the device button. This button over here. It has only two lines of code. Of course, you need to test all those things, rather this is not empty or stuff like that, but I don't in these videos. So we're gonna use the name of our string because we need to put the string together. So cmd fmpeg is tfbrowse.txt, meaning the location of fmpeg, that's this here, that's the location where fmpeg is in your computer when you build this. Then we're gonna say plus, and then you see these double quotes, and this is a string variable, minus list underscore devices. What does it do? It simply builds a list of your hardware. That's basically what it is, because here you see my sound card. This here is my sound card. This should be a microphone, a mic, and well, some other information you can see over here. Then true, minus F, D show, minus I, and then dummy. Now I will explain in other videos what that means, not in this one, it's not necessary. And then we're going to say fmpeg shell dot execute. Now what does it need to execute this particular shell? Well, this here. So we're going to simply say cmd fmpeg, and then you get this here. That's basically all there is. Now I will show you that it really works. I will close this one, I will click on him, simply do browse, let me see where it is, really short. This is fmpeg, open devices, there you go. No one ever saw that fmpeg was started. And here you have my sound card. That's basically it for this video. How you can keep something on the background so no one knows what you use. So simply this here is, let me get this out of the way. This here simply an interface to fmpeg. You do not install it. You simply make use of it with the shell. And that's basically it for this video. This works in a similar way, of course, but I'm going to show you that in future videos. So hopefully you enjoyed this video, and well, see each other with another video.